Okay, hello friends, welcome to my channel. So for this Rakhi, I have made these two terrariums to give a gift to my brothers and sisters. This is a succulent terrarium, this one is a succulent terrarium, and this is a tropical terrarium. See, when you are going to give a gift, when you are giving a terrarium as a gift, just go with the simple plants, which are very easy to care, very hardy plants. Don't go for exotic plants, go for easy to care plants. And when you want to gift terrarium to someone, just you have to take care of two things according to me. That one is what kind of person he or she is, to whom you are going to gift it, whether he is very busy, he's very busy in his schedule, that he's a lazy kind of a person, then go for a hardy plants. So little bit ignorance plants should tolerate. And the second thing, what kind of light the one is getting in his house. So those factors you have to consider, whether if there is a south facing opening, then you can gift succulent plants as well as house plants also. But if there is no south facing opening, then north facing opening is there, then you have to go with the house plants. So accordingly you should design, you should plan for the terrarium. My one brother is having a south facing opening, so I have made this terrarium. This is a guest area plant I have planted in this, and this is normal pothos or neon money plant I have used, and this is a syngonium I have used in it. Simple decoration I have used. There is no as such rocket science behind making of terrarium. Very easy. Take any kind of a ball like this. This kind of a mason jar, or this kind of a mason jar you can use. Just take a mason jar, put any kind of a soil, any kind of a garden soil I mean to say, or just a cocoa pit if you are having, just put it in this and plant any propagated plant, and your terrarium is ready. If you are having this kind of a mason jar, just add this thick layer of a sand like this. I have used in this thick layer of a sand. Then on that thick layer, just put the soil and just plant the plant. Simple plant, you can go with the syngoniums or you can go with the money plant. The plant which we can grow easily in Mumbai, select such plants. So now let's see the making of these terrariums. And watch the video till the end, because I have just changed this layering. The layering of this is in the sequence of, first there will be the gravels layer, then there is a sphagnum moss layer, then there is a charcoal, and then we add the soil. But I have changed the layering, and why I have done so, that I will tell at the end of this video. So watch the video till the end. Thank you.
this is a propagated plant. This is an old leaf that I'm going to cut now, and these are the new leaves. The old leaf I'm cutting here. Here also, this one is also propagated. The old leaf I'm cutting. Here also, this extra part I'm cutting.
Thank you.
usually I put the gravels layer, that is a drainage layer, first. But in this I have used charcoal first, because the gravels layer, if it will come to the eyesight level, it looks beautiful. But what happens when you put it down, it goes down, those gravels, they go down and we cannot see, it's not visible. So it's like, I feel it's a vestige of those gravels we are using. So what I have done in this, I have put the charcoal at the bottom, so that is not visible, then it's okay. Then on that I have used these gravels here, in this also, in this terrarium also I have done same thing. See, there is a charcoal is first, which is not visible, but then I have used these gravels so that they will come to the level of eyesight, so it's visible. These gravels are visible and it looks, I like that. I like to see these gravels. According to me, these gravels should be at the level of eyesight, so it looks beautiful. So I have put the charcoal down. So we are using the charcoal, and as the charcoal is there down, and because of that, the size of this layering is getting reduced, and this pot size is a 8-inch pot I have taken. I have used, and one more thing is that when you are gifting someone the terrarium, try to use a single plant. Don't make it too much overcrowded. It will be easy for the one to handle those plants. Soil for the succulent terrarium that I used always is a Mandis soil. Its link I will give in the description box. For the tropical terrarium, according to me, you can go with the normal cocopeat. If you are not having the soil, just use cocopeat, it's all fine. But actually, what should be the soil mix, that I will give in the description box. In this particularly, I have used the cocopeat and the perlite. I don't have compost right now, and my compost has got over, so I have not added the compost. It's optional whether you want to add the compost or not. Even if you'll use the just cocopeat, that is also fine for the plants like pothos and syngonium. Check the description box for the soil mix that you can use for this tropical terrarium. So when you are making a terrarium of succulent plant, you can get the plants from nursery directly. You can use the plants in a terrarium as they are small in size. But when you are going for the tropical terrarium, when you are going for the tropical plants, you should propagate those plants and use baby plants in the terrarium. If you'll bring the plant from the nursery and if you'll use it, it is not going to work. That is what is my experience. So I always, when I'm making a terrarium of tropical plants, I propagate my plants and then I use those plants, those baby plants in terrarium. Then only I get the success. So this is the way I have made this terrariums. Hope you have liked it. If you have liked it, please give a thumbs up. And if you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe the channel and stay tuned to my channel. Thanks for watching.